Hello everyone, welcome back to the course Application Development using Python. In the previous sessions, we have discussed about writing a simple program and understanding each line of it. In this session, we will be discussing about basics of flow control. That is, we will be starting with Boolean values. Let us see what is Boolean values with the interactive shell. So now I will be opening my interactive shell, which is already installed with the Python. So Boolean values will be having only two values, that is true or false. So we will see that how Python will evaluate that Boolean values. So just I will write true in the Python shell. So it is evaluating it as a true. And also you can observe here that is true is in the red color. That means it is a keyword and it is already understood by the Python. Okay, so next one more values, false. Okay, so this is also evaluated. Let me write true in another way. So that is true in the small letter, T is small here. So you can observe here that is so yeah. Okay. Okay. Let me write let us see the Boolean values. So let me write true in the interactive shell. Let us see how Python will evaluate this work. So you can observe Python is evaluating that same way. Another value that is false. So false also evaluated in the Python. Let me write true in another way, that is small t. So you can observe here true is not evaluated because it is not recognized by the Python. Same way another value, Boolean values, false. So here also I have started with the small letter f. So let us see that it is evaluating or not. So you can the Python is throwing an error, that is name error. Name true is not defined. Same way name false is also not defined. Okay, so let me initialize this true to the another variable. Span is equal to true. Okay, so now span is initialized with the value true. So let me see that how span is evaluated. You can observe here that is span is evaluated to true because we have assigned it. Okay, next one more options. Let me check that true. I'm initializing that true with some other variable. So you can observe here the true, that is Boolean values, cannot be assigned with any other values. Okay, so next let us continue with the operators. Okay, so that is specially in the flow control we have to concentrate on comparison operator. Okay, comparison operator, if you take, so when we want to check equality, then we have to use equal symbol. Okay, so that is equal to, we call it as equal to. Another one is if you check not equal, then you have to use exclamatory mark and equal symbol. So there you can check that not equal. And next one, if you want to check any numbers or any values are less than or greater than, then you can use less than symbol or greater than symbol. Okay, you can observe it on screen. I'm still writing in the interactive shell only for your understanding. Next, one more option is sometimes the values will be less than or equal, greater than or equal. So then you can write less than and equal symbol, and same way greater than and equal symbol. Okay, so this is how the few comparator operators you can use it for flow control. Okay, let us begin with the small expressions, small expressions. That is, let me check 42 is equal to 42. So obviously Python will return with the values, that is Boolean values. Okay, so you can observe here 42 is equal to 42 and it is evaluated to true. So one statement I want to make it here, that is, any comparison or comparator or comparison operations will be finally evaluated to Boolean values, that is true or false. Okay, so let me check that 42 is equal to 96 or 89. Okay, I have written here 89, so it is false. So you can observe here, this is evaluated to Boolean values, what I made just one statement, that is any comparisons, that is evaluated to Boolean values. Is it 2 is not equal to 3? Okay, it is true. Okay, so Boolean values, it is evaluated to true. Okay, so let me check with the, till now we are checking with the normal string. We were checking with the normal integer. Let us go with the string values. Okay, hello. Is it hello is equal to Sahyadri? So it is not equal, so it will return or evaluate it to false. So let me check Sahyadri is equal to Sahyadri. It is true. Okay, so this is how string can be evaluated. I have one more option, so let me check that is that Sahyadri not equal to Mangaluru. It is obviously a human understandable form, that is directly we can say it is not equal, but let us see that what Python will tell us. It is true. Okay, so next let me check that integer value comparing with the floating point value. Let me check 32 is equal to 32.0 or not, that is integer and floating point I'm comparing, so it is evaluating to true because it is equal. Okay, so one more check I have to do, or comparisons I want to do, is that 32 is equal to string value 32. So it is not, it is not, because 32 in the second part, what after comparator, comparator operator, what I have mentioned is a string, and the first part is the integer. It is not considering that both are equal, it is returning with the false. Okay, till now I was going through that equality, checking equality. So now I will go with the less than or greater than operator. Uh, 42 is less than 100, true. 43 greater than 42, true. Next, I will initialize some egg is the one simple variable, initializing with the 42. And next I am comparing that, is that egg greater than 56? It is false. So you can observe here variable, you can compare with the numbers, that is since it has been in the previous line we have assigned some values to that particular variable egg. So in that case the 42 is greater than 56, it is false, it is evaluated to false. And next I will check that, is that egg greater than or equal to 56. Let me check this how it will evaluate. Okay, see, still it is false. So egg, actually I have initialized to what, 42. So let me check, is that 42 or equal to or greater than 42? It is true, because if it is greater or equal, then it will check. Okay, let me check that egg greater than or equal to 41. If I see, so then also it is true, right? Because egg 42 and I'm checking with 41, it is true. Okay, so one more operations, greater than or just greater than 42, I will check. Okay, we have initialized with egg 42. I'm checking that is that egg is greater than 42. So it is false, because it is equal to 42. We have checked that how Python will evaluate. Okay, next part is we are going with the Boolean operators. So how with the help of this comparator operator we are checking and how it is evaluated to Boolean values. Now we'll go with the Boolean operators. Okay, let me write in the shell Boolean operators, like how comparator operators are there, same way Boolean operators are there. So how these Boolean operators are working, that we will see. So true, it's the Boolean value, and true here and operations I'm going to do. Okay, so true and true, that is true. If it is true and false, so then it is 1 multiplied with 0, that is 0, false. So false and false, so it is false, false and true, it is false. So AND operations we have seen, that is AND is a one Boolean operator. With the help of Boolean operator I'm trying to evaluate that different combination. Same way OR operator is one more Boolean operator, so I'm trying to evaluate that also. True or true, this is 1 plus 1, so it is true. Same way true or false, it is true only, because any one operand or value is true, it will definitely evaluate to true only, since it is OR operators. So false or false, so then it is false. So one more combinations I have left is false or true, so it is true. Okay, so this is how we can use these Boolean operators to evaluate any expressions. Let us go with merging this comparator operator and Boolean operators. Before that, NOT is the one more operators you should know, that is NOT, the keyword also small letter NOT, N-O-T. So let me check NOT true. Not true, it will do negation of the true, so negation of true is the false. Okay, so not false, let me check, so it is evaluated to false. So next, let us go with the mixing this Boolean and comparison operator. Okay, so let me write one simple expression, 4 less than 5. Okay, 4 less than 5, and I'm multiplying with 5 less than 6. So here you can observe 4 less than 5 is the left side of the AND operator is evaluated, so in that case it is true, and right side of that AND operator 5 is less than 6, that is also true. So if you check, it is evaluated to true. Same way 3 less than 2, if I check, and 7 greater than 9, if I check, obviously it will return false because both the side it is false only, evaluated to false. So next, this is how we can evaluate this operations. One more, some little more bigger expressions I will try to write right now. So 2 plus 2, okay, is equal to 4 and not of 2 plus 2 is equal to 5 and 2 multiplied with the 2 is equal to 2 plus 2. Okay, here somewhat bigger operations we are trying this. So 2 plus 2 is 4 and 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. 2 plus 2 is equal to, that is 2, and after that AND operation, 2 plus 2, 4, that is false, but we are negating it, that is true only, true, and again that AND operations here, it will be true. So all the statements will be evaluated to true. So this is how we can use these Boolean values and the comparison operators and Boolean operators in the programming. In the next sessions, we will be going with the basics of flow control. Thank you and happy learning.